I'm Assistant Sheriff Charles Hank, and I'm going to brief you on additional details as we know them today regarding the officer-involved shooting that occurred on March 15, 2019. This incident occurred on a busy Friday night at a strip hotel and involved a brazen criminal who showed no regard for his victims and was willing to use deadly force on a police officer in order to make his escape. This is officer-involved shooting number 4 for 2019, fatal number 1. Same time last year, we were at officer-involved shooting number 3, fatal number 1. This was a robbery call that occurred on March 15th, 2019 at 9:49 p.m. The location was 3600 South Las Vegas Boulevard, which is the Bellagio Hotel and Casino, which is located within our Convention Center Area Command. Shots were fired at approximately 9:49 p.m. The involved officer is Officer Joaquin Escobar, is J-O-A-Q-U-I-N, last name E-S-C-O-B-A-R. He is 29 years old and has been with the Las Vegas Metropolitan Police Department for 2 years. In this incident, Officer Escobar was armed with a Glock 17, 9mm handgun, equipped with a tactical light. The investigation revealed he fired one round during this incident. The suspect, Michael Cohen, he is a 49-year-old white male adult, 5'7", 185 pounds. Cohen's weapon was a Smith & Wesson Bodyguard 380 caliber handgun. The investigation revealed the suspect Cohen fired one round during this incident. Cohen's criminal history. Cohen is a convicted felon for bank robbery, 2 counts in 1999 in Nevada. Bank robbery, 2 counts, 2008, Nevada. His prior arrests include bank robbery, kidnap, carjacking, possession of narcotics paraphernalia, possession of stolen property, and several misdemeanor and traffic charges. Cohen's charges, had he survived, would be attempt murder on a protected person, robbery with a deadly weapon, 2 counts, prohibited person in possession of a firearm, burglary with a firearm, attempt grand larceny auto with a firearm, as well as carrying a concealed weapon. The details of the event. On Friday, March 15th, at approximately 9:45 p.m., detectives and patrol officers were at the Bellagio following a missing person case. Following up on a missing person case. As part of that follow-up, detectives were in the security surveillance room conducting part of their investigation. While they were conducting that investigation, Cohen entered the Bellagio poker room and robbed a casino cage at gunpoint. Cohen fled with cash and casino chips he stole from the cage and exited through the north doors into the valet area. Detectives and Bellagio security officers in the surveillance room followed Cohen and broadcast his description of movements on the Convention Center Area Command radio channel. Let me just be clear, because sometimes folks get a little bit confused. Bellagio actually has 2 valet areas, one on the east side, which is on Las Vegas Boulevard. This valet area is on the north side, which exits out to Flamingo Road. Detectives and Bellagio security officers in the surveillance room followed Cohen and broadcast his description and movements on the Convention Center Area Command radio channel. When Cohen exited the hotel, he entered an unoccupied white Mercedes-Benz parked in the valet area in an attempt to take the car, but could not locate any keys. He then exited the Mercedes-Benz and approached a black BMW vehicle that just pulled into the valet area. Cohen attempted to open the driver's door, but the driver's door was locked and the driver would not open the door. The female driver of the BMW pulled the car forward, and Cohen pulled out his firearm, tapped on the driver's window with the firearm, and pointed it at the driver. The four LVMPD officers that were in the valet area heard the radio broadcast of the robbery and Cohen's description and realized Cohen was in front of them attempting to carjack the BMW. The four officers issued verbal commands to Cohen to get on the ground, but Cohen refused. Cohen stepped back and fired one round, striking an officer in the chest, which fortunately was protected by his bulletproof vest. That's the shirt he was wearing at the time, and that's his vest. The officer stumbled back and knocked over two officers. Cohen began to run across the valet lanes as Officer Escobar fired one round, striking Cohen in the head. Cohen was taken into custody, and medical personnel transported him to UMC Trauma, where he was pronounced deceased at 3:17 a.m. Our detectives have been able to determine that Cohen is the same suspect who robbed the cashier cage at Bellagio in November of 2017. We will now show you body-worn camera footage and surveillance video from this incident. What you're looking at now is the officers are standing, well, once it starts, they're standing there, and you'll see him. That's him right there. He just left the Mercedes, and he walked over to the BMW. In a moment, the camera will pan to the left as the officer engage him. They're now receiving radio traffic that he's out there. You'll see another view of that incident as well. This is now the Bellagio video. That's him exiting the door, running. They're zooming in. He now goes to the white Mercedes, gets in, and appears he no keys, and he gets out and then goes back to the BMW. This is where he attempts to get in the car. He'll momentarily pull out the firearm and tap on the window, and he'll pull forward. The officers will then come around and engage him in a moment. He now has a gun out. Officers give him commands. He fires on the officer. It's now in slow motion. He's now at the black BMW up at the top left. It's moving forward another angle. They're giving him commands, and he fires on the officer. Okay, with that, I'll now open it up for any questions.
Can you just comment on how brazen this man was, even when he was taking those two cars, those four Metro officers were standing there, obviously no disregard for them here in this case. Can you just kind of talk about just how reckless this man was, and unfortunately, he, you know, lost his life here, but can you just talk about just how brazen he was through this whole ordeal?
Well, I think he was extremely brazen, given the fact that you go to the Strip and walk in an extremely populated casino with the number of people there and commit this type of crime. And I'm just very grateful that our officers were present and took the action that they did and that they're okay, as well as the community members and visitors in our community are okay.
Considering this started in the poker room and he made it all the way out there to the valet area where he got in not one, but tried to get in two different vehicles, and the fact that only two people really were involved in this incident being shot, how fortunate is it that nobody in the community, no other officers were hit?
I believe it's extremely fortunate, and I'm also feel that we're fortunate that that our officer's vest stopped that round. This could have been very tragic for both our officers as well as citizens within our community, or even that lady that was in her car, or imagine had someone else been in that other car, this could have been an extremely unfortunate event.
How are you able to connect the two robberies from 2017?
Well, I think if you look at that image, there's bandages on the left side of the face. He had bandages on the left side of his face. On the most recent one, he had, it's a bandage under that. He also puts a cell phone up there. You see the hoodie, which is being worn as well as the glasses and a black beanie. So we're relatively certain that he's very likely the same suspect from 2017.
Any connection to any other crimes that you guys were still investigating?
There's no other crimes that I'm aware of this time that we're still investigating related to this subject.
How much money did he get away with?
I don't have the exact amount, but and we're not going to share that at this time.
What was taken in November?
I believe cash and casino chips again.
Was it also the poker room?
Yes, same location. Take one more question, if any.
Of the officer who was shot in the bulletproof vest, would you, if not a name, will you tell us age and service history?
I don't have that right now. I will say that he was immediately released after being seen at UMC, and he is doing well.
That makes us ask why there are two holes.
It appears it was a glancing type shot where it went across the vest, and part of that, I believe, on his lower left and your right as you face it, that was one of the bullet fragments as it fragmented there. That's it. Thank you, folks. Have a good afternoon.